to understand the issues with using the bathroom in space, you ought to start with a foundational knowledge of how the system is designed and how they train you to use it.
Yeah.
Okay? So if you're going to use the bathroom in space, you start with really two types of problems, liquid waste disposal and solid waste disposal. And the apparatus of the toilet is designed as follows. You know, there's for urine disposal, mm-hmm. there's basically a vacuum cleaner connected to a tube with a funnel on the top, and you basically just have to pee in the funnel.
Yeah.
And then there's a centrifugal separator to separate liquids from gases, and then it's stored. And that actually works quite well. And there's a round funnel for guys and a lozenge-shaped funnel for girls, but otherwise it works fine. The real issue is solid waste disposal. The way the unit is designed is sitting on the floor is basically an aluminum beer keg that has the same vacuum hose attached to it. On top of that is basically something the size of a shoebox that has the toilet seat, you know, so to speak. It has a lid on top of it. And inside that toilet seat is about a Coke can-sized insert with a lip around the top where you can put a plastic bag about the size of a Coke can and a rubber band that holds the plastic bag to the top. And the theory is that any solids that come out of you are drawn into the plastic bag by the flow of the air. When you have filled the plastic bag and cleaned yourself up and put anything else in the plastic bag to dispose of, you can lift a little red tab on the plastic bag, it closes and will be drawn into the beer keg container underneath you. And then after about a week, that beer keg will fill up with little bags, at which point in time you seal it up, you throw it in the progress. When that progress is full, you inject this all into space and it becomes a shooting star that we all see at night. That's the theory of operation, and that's about all anybody tells you about it. You can't actually train that on gravity because things don't operate the same in zero G's gravity, so you've never actually done this. So the first time you go to the bathroom in space, there's some interesting issues. So one of the first issues that comes up is that your whole GI tract actually slows way down in space because, you're on Earth, you're moving around, it helps you be modal, and if you go to the bathroom, say, once a day on Earth, you only go to the bathroom about once every 5 days in space. So by the time you need to go to the bathroom in space, you really need to go to the bathroom, fairly urgently. And now I'm going to start with a metaphor to describe one of the first problems. So I'm going to use toothpaste as an experimental metaphor. So if you're on the Earth, you squeeze a tube of toothpaste over your sink in the hotel. Toothpaste will come out, gravity will curve it down toward the sink, and when a few grams of it is hanging out of the toothpaste tube, it will break off of the toothpaste tube and fall into the sink. If you do the same experiment in space, squeeze a tube of toothpaste, a few grams will come out, and just hang there. Squeeze some more, a few more grams will come out. Squeeze some more, a few more grams will come out. If you try to pull the toothpaste tube away, it will all come with you. Okay? So this is what has never been described to you on the ground. So you situate yourself over the toilet seat, you begin the process, and within a fraction of a second, or 2 or 3 seconds, you've created a column that connects you to the bottom of the plastic bag. And so you stop and go, oh, well, what do I do now? Because no one has described this moment to you. And so you're going like, okay, well, the one thing they have told you is how dangerous feces is in the ISS. Because it's literally the most hazardous contaminant that is anywhere in the local environment, your enclosed environment, and the bathroom is right next to the galley where all the food is prepared. I mean, and you've been told horror stories about how this is all broken before, and you're going like, oh man, I really don't want to mess this up. Literally, so to speak. So everybody figures out, the next moment everybody kind of figures out apparently, it's named after an Apollo astronaut, I always forget, but I'll try to get that for you, which is this bounce maneuver. You learn to kind of bounce, and that will break things off of you, so they instead now settled into the plastic bag. But now you have a new problem, which is this plastic bag the size of a Coke can now has a diagonal obstruction in it. And so if you just continue, you're going to have the same problem, but even sooner. So you go like, well, now what I do? Because I'm only 10% of the way through my process. So how do I continue? And you look around for other resources, and the only other things in the bathroom are, it's not really toilet paper, but you have wet wipes, and you have rubber gloves for handling all these parts and pieces and all this kind of stuff. So you go, well, I guess I got to get things out of the way. And so you use things like wet wipes to manually manipulate things out of the way in the plastic bag so that you then can continue. And after another round, you repeat the process. So you go through this repetitive process of clearing space in the receptacle for you to continue your business. You finally finish your business, you clean up, you put everything in the bag, you remove the rubber band, it falls in like it was supposed to, But this process took 45 minutes. So when you finally emerge from the bathroom, your crewmates are all sitting there around the galley all like, ha, 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 ha. Like, everyone like, man, you know, I had to invent all this stuff in real time. Did I do it wrong? I mean, is this really what you're expected to do? And they're all like, yeah, that's the process. You've now survived the gauntlet of how to use the bathroom. And what was really funny about it is after I got back, I went on a British children's show, kind of like the Sesame Street thing, called Blue Peter. And they said they had a space toilet they wanted me to narrate about. And I'd never seen the toilet until they rolled it out on stage, on live television. They pulled out this toilet, and it wasn't the same toilet I used. It was actually the toilet that was designed for Mir 2, which was never flown. And it had a much bigger aperture and a much deeper plastic bag. And I couldn't say it because, you know, I was on real time on television, but I was going, that's the toilet we should have had. And I'm going like, there actually is a toilet that's better. But it, for some reason, they never installed it, or it's never been flown. But again, if I were to re-engineer something in space, first thing I would do is re-engineer the toilet.